and welcome to our shop. I understand that you're looking for a new water bottle. Yes, okay. So, I think it's very important to keep yourself hydrated, and I'm gonna assume that you feel similarly, or else you wouldn't be here today. Myself, I normally carry around a water bottle or keep one nearby when I'm going about my normal day and also on the job. I've set aside four different models for us to look at today. When we're looking at these, what I want you to keep in mind is what are you going to use the bottle for? What you use a water bottle for really affects what the correct water bottle is for that task. It's pretty much impossible to have one water bottle that's the right water bottle for every task that you're trying to complete. And that's because a good water bottle is specialized to the task that it's doing, right? Now, that doesn't mean that you can't get away with just one water bottle, but it's not necessarily going to be the best bottle for everything that you're going to want to do with it. Okay? So, give me a moment and I'll grab the first bottle. Okay, so I grabbed the first water bottle, and that first one is going to be the Nalgene with the narrow top. All four of these bottles that we're looking at today are actually coming from my own personal collection. So you might see a little bit of wear and tear on each of them, but don't worry. If you select one of these bottles today, we'll be sure to get you your own new version that hasn't been opened yet. But these are just what I had on hand, easily accessible. So these are the ones I'm going to actually be showing you today. So the Nalgene is a great bottle. It comes in at 1,000 milliliters. That's just over 32 fluid ounces for you American system users. It's a great bottle. It's not insulated. It's just a bit of plastic, but they're extremely durable. So these can be a great choice if you're doing something, maybe you're going hiking or you're going for a run, someplace where you're going to be kind of beating up on your water bottle a lot. I think these are great for that because you don't have to worry about them getting damaged, like some of the models that we're going to talk about a little bit later. So, another situation where this bottle can be great is if you're going to the gym or somewhere where you're not really worried about the contents, typically assuming water, but it could be something else, getting too hot or too cold. Because it's not insulated, if that's not a concern, then you don't need to worry about it, and it holds a nice large amount of fluid in a package that isn't too big. If you get kind of narrower bottles, then as you get to the higher fluid volumes, they're just going to get really tall and they get kind of difficult to carry. This one's a nice shape. It's nice and easy to hold. One of my favorite ways to hold it is actually take your thumb, hook it through here, and then grab. It's a nice solid hold. Doesn't matter if you have big hands or small hands. I actually have pretty small hands, and I find that way I'm able to easily grip it. It's full of water, it can get a little bit heavy, and this sometimes gets tiring. Or if you're running with it, again, thumb through, grasp, and then you can kind of put it in the crook of your elbow here, just like that, and carry it like a football. Works really well. I used to run with one of these all the time, and I find it's one of the easiest bottles to carry that way. But if you're going to be, again, taking it somewhere where it's going to get really hot or really cold, and you're worried about the temperature of what's inside of here, this is not going to be a great choice. Because of the clear nature, too, it sometimes doesn't look as nice if you're taking it to work or something like that, somewhere where you're concerned about how it looks. This isn't necessarily the cutest or nicest looking bottle, it's more utilitarian. So, I'm going to set this one aside and move on to our next bottle. Our next one is going to be the Clean Canteen. I don't use this one a lot, actually. My partner likes to use this one a lot. She says that it's really great and has great things to say about it. What I can tell you are some things I know about it, just from working around water bottles a lot. It is a stainless steel construction, which means that it feels nice in the hand. It has okay temperature regulation properties. It's not insulated like one of the bottles I'm going to show you later, but it will do a little bit better than Nalgene did. So this one is 500 milliliters, or just over that. So this is about half the size of the Nalgene. about the same height, but it's actually quite a bit smaller. So if that's something that really matters to you, this is going to be a great bottle for you. Now, one thing I personally don't really like is this top. It pulls out, pushes in. I find that these kind of wear out a little bit over time. They get harder to use. They get kind of stuck. I'm just not a big fan of them, but the flip side is they are a little bit easier to kind of get a nice steady drink out of without having to worry about pouring it all over yourself. So for professional settings, this is a great option because you're never going to get that pool of water kind of on your shirt or something like that, which is not going to look good if you have a big important meeting coming up or something like that. The stainless steel is not, however, something I recommend if you are concerned about durability. A lot of stainless steel bottles, the Clean Canteen included, will have damage if you just kind of toss them. So like when I used to run, I sometimes would take a stainless steel and I would, you know, I'd be running and then I'd get wherever I was going or something, I kind of just tossed to the side. You hit a rock, you'll quickly find you're getting punctures and damage on the bottle that is both going to show and sometimes will go all the way through, and then you're not going to be able to hold water in it anymore. So if you're just taking to the office or the gym, these are great options. Although again, I don't really like this kind of top for the gym because I find when I'm at the gym, I'm working out hard. Maybe I've just been running on an elliptical for a half an hour. I'm, you know, breathing pretty heavy and I really want something to drink. I find that these tops just don't let you get enough liquid fast enough for what you're really looking for in that situation. But for times when you're not needing to just gulp down water, it can be great. It's a very low mess. Which actually brings me back to the Nalgene. One thing I forgot to tell you about on the Nalgene is that this is the narrow top. There's a wider top. I don't have one with me, unfortunately, right now. But they're the same cost. The wider top is maybe about this big. Covers almost the whole top area, which means that you can get the water a lot faster, or if you're just looking to pour it on yourself because you're really hot, it's really great. However, this one I generally prefer. It's not that hard to drink out of. You can get a nice pour without really worrying about splashing too much. If you really still want to pour it on yourself, you can. It's just a little bit slower, as I've just done there. The only downside is if you're trying to put ice into your water, this narrow top, there's no way to make it wider, so it can be a little bit difficult to get the water that you're looking for, or get the ice in there, I'm sorry. So give me one moment and I'll get the next bottle. So the next bottle that I have for you today is the Swell bottle. This is the wood finish. This is my personal most used bottle. So the Swell bottle is also made of stainless steel, so it's going to have some of the similar drawbacks to the Clean Canteen that we just showed you. They're both right about 500 milliliters. This one's slightly more. This one is right on 500 milliliters, so slightly more capacity. But if you look at the size, the Swell bottle actually is bigger. It's got a bigger footprint, it's a little bit taller, and they're about the same width, maybe slightly narrower. The advantage of the Swell bottle over the Clean Canteen, however, if you open it, you see the lid, and on the inside, it's hard to see, but if you feel it, yeah, it's actually it's insulated on the inside. So what this is going to do, basically, is it's going to keep whatever you put in it at the temperature you put it in. Typically with water, it's going to keep your water cold, and I find that it works very well. I'm outside maybe playing tennis for 2-3 hours, this will keep it as cold as when I first put the water in. I can't notice any difference, so I've been really impressed with the Swell bottle's insulation properties. There are a lot of knockoffs of this bottle. I recommend the genuine article. I think it holds up a little bit better than some of the knockoffs, but you know, your mileage may vary. So one disadvantage of this one is it's a little bit heavier than that Clean Canteen was. So if you don't care about that insulating properties, maybe you're going to the gym again and it's going to be a nice air-conditioned space. You don't need that. You're going to be carrying a lot of extra weight for that insulation for a feature that you might not really care about. So that's something to kind of keep in mind when you choose this wall bottle. Again, it's got a similar head size or mouth size to what the Nalgene had, the narrow bottled Nalgene. So just keep that in mind when you're selecting which is the right bottle for you. Again, this is a stainless steel, so if you're going to be really abusing it, it's going to dent. With the insulation, it's going to be a little bit harder to puncture this one than the clean canteen, but it could still happen. So just be mindful of that when you're kind of selecting. This bottle also comes in a couple of different sizes. There's a slightly smaller one and there's one that's taller. I think the medium size is the best one for most people in most uses. The small one's just a little too little in my opinion. It's only like two or three sips of water and then it feels like you're gone. And the big one with the insulation is just so big and so heavy that I find it's impractical to carry around. But if that doesn't bother you, then we can look at that option as well. Again, this is just what I had available to kind of show you, and this is the one that I recommend you get if you decide you want a swell bottle. It also comes in a variety of different finishes and colors. The two other bottles did as well, but those typically just come in different colors, whereas this one is going to come in, there's this wood finish, there's different shiny finishes, a couple of different matte finishes. So there's a lot of different options out there if this is the route that you want to take. So I have one more option. So this is the last option. And this one might seem a little bit strange to you at first, but hear me out. So this is actually a coffee mug. It's made by Ello, E-L-L-O, and it's an insulated ceramic mug. And while this might seem a little bit strange, if you're looking for a water bottle, why am I showing you a coffee mug? Because frankly, if you're not someone who needs, some of the features specific to one of those other bottles, this might just be a better option for you. This bottle is going to hold a slightly smaller amount of liquid, but not that far off. The lid comes on and off pretty easily. Just pull out. And then it's got this nice click open, click shut lid right there. So what this is going to offer to you is some of the insulation properties of the swell bottle, maybe slightly less because it's, the top isn't as insulated, but similar kind of properties. It's easy to fill, holds a decent amount of liquid. And if you're not looking for kind of a task that requires one of those more specialized water bottles, this can be nice because it's just going to let you use it for coffee on your way into the office, rinse it out, fill it up, now you have water the rest of the day. You don't have to have a special bottle for every function. So if you're someone who's maybe not that big of a water drinker or isn't really sure that you need another water bottle but you feel like you maybe do, this can be a great option because, again, it's going to serve that multi-function of being a coffee mug and being a water bottle. And I find that a lot of people really like this option. They haven't really thought about it, but once they try it, they find that it's really nice. This particular mug, it's really nice. It's got a nice weight to it. It's not too heavy, but it feels solid in your hand with that ceramic. And then it's got a nice silicon grip to it, so it doesn't feel like it's going to fall out of your hand ever. And if you set it on a table, it's nice and solid, but it doesn't, clink because it's got silicon on the bottom as well. So if you drop it, you've got a little bit of protection as well. So those are kind of the four main bottles that I have for you guys, for you today. Do you have any questions? Which type of bottle are you kind of thinking? What are the tasks that you are looking to use your bottle for? So you're just kind of looking for an all-purpose bottle. Yeah, that's kind of tricky. Like I said, the one that I use the most is the Swell bottle, but I think any one of them can be a great option for an all-purpose bottle. So I would just kind of recommend take a little bit of time, feel them each in your hand, and then decide which one you think is right for you. Okay? Great. Well, I hope I was able to help you today. Have a good day.